Hey, everybody. Hope you are doing well. We're going to go back and visit the album Heavy Load Blues by Government Mule. And this song was on my to-do list already, but there was a viewer who wrote in on a previous track we did, the song Heavy Load, and they suggested that we do a song called Have Mercy on the Criminal. Like I said, it was already in my to-do list, so I'm happy to do it, more than happy to do it. This album was Government Mule's first offering of a straight, pure blues album. Blues has always been part of their sound, but they're more of a blues rock, jam band, rock kind of group. I always describe them to people as sort of like if you were to take the Allman Brothers and mesh them with Cream and throw a little Black Sabbath in there. And of course, that was right on their very first album. That's what I thought. And then as they've developed and grown as a band, their styles have just branched out to infinite levels of versatility. But this album was released in 2022, and it was their intention for it to be a pure blues album. And so without any further ado, let's check out the song Have Mercy on the Criminal.
Blind to the winds of change. Won't you hear them out?
I love the live in the studio feel behind this album. And this song is a great example of that too. It's just, you can hear that they're playing with each other. They're playing to each other. And, you know, you can go on Instagram into Government Mule or Warren Haynes's Instagram feed, and you can go back and actually look at some of the images from the recording of this album and the upcoming album. They recorded two albums basically at the same time. The album that's coming up is more of a traditional Government Mule rock album, but when they get to the images of them recording this Heavy Load Blues album, you can see them basically playing in a circular formation with all of the members of the band playing towards one another. And there's no overdubs. It's just straight live in the studio recording, almost like they would have done it back in the 1920s and 30s with, you know, just players and a microphone recording direct to acetate. It's just obviously they have more technology and better sound. But they recorded it intentionally to have that live in the studio feel that not too many bands are willing to do these days. And there's a lot of that on a lot of Government Mule albums, but they really intentionally did it on this one. And it is spectacular playing and writing. With that said, thanks for watching. Please feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below. We can talk about it further. Know that I appreciate you and I wish you all well. Take care.